Now what we can do is remember that the next time that you find yourself, as I explained before, that you find yourself very detached or overly attached to your emotions, then with any other person, of course, then you can begin to go through these six steps which we have mentioned to recognize your emotions after every event. So these six steps can be applied to every situation you come across, whether it might be a positive or a negative situation, and then it helps you to actually label what emotion you are feeling at that particular moment. So in this we can see that I'll just read out the steps. What exactly happened? You need to understand what you can probably do is, while I'm just going through the steps, you can probably think of some situation and then relate to the questions which I have put forth here, and then you might easily be able to. Yeah.
Nothing. Just trying to.
Answer. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so what you can do is, you can probably pick up a situation in your mind, no need to put forth it here, but you can, it'll be easy for you to relate to these steps and understand how you can, how you are starting off with the emotion which you really felt that you were experiencing at that moment, and by the end of the sixth question, you actually understand ki, okay, achha, this is not exactly what I was, what emotion or what feeling I had in my mind when I started the steps. So basically, what happened, why did it happen, and how did it make you feel, what did you want to do at that particular moment, what did you do and say when you knew about the situation and when you knew about how you're feeling. And the most important question here, which is really important, is how did it affect you. So there can be some situations which can affect you mentally and physically as well. But generally what people do is that when something affects you physically, medicine is easily available for that. And we also focus on this thing that it is not only that your physical symptoms need medicine and need to be treated, but mental health should be equally important. So if it is affecting you, if that situation is affecting you in any way, any psychological way, any disturbances in your emotional, I would say how you are feeling it, or it is bothering you, it is definitely the time you need to speak up and talk to someone, I would suggest. So these are the six steps for recognizing your emotions. Next slide, Pranita. Yeah. So now I have told you what exactly emotions are, how you can recognize emotions, just give me a moment to think of something. So you can actually, you can bifurcate your emotions. You can come to an emotion, like you're starting from a very different emotion and you're coming to a different emotion. You're understanding it, recognizing it, accepting it, accepting that you are feeling this way. This is the emotion, and accepting it, of course. So I have explained you everything. Now the common question which people feel is that, you have explained how we can deal with emotions. You have told us what steps we need to follow. And in the further slide, Pranita will be explaining us how we can manage and deal with them. So then why is the need for a mental health professional to come into the scene? What can a mental health professional do different than what you guys are explaining through slides? So this is not the way, this is not the thing. This is a very, 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 very basic background of what we are presenting to you. This is like, I would say, like the surface level, what we are putting out in front of you of emotions and any other aspect of psychology, I would say. Just to give you an example of why you need to go to a mental health professional and when you need to go to a mental health professional, I'll give you an example of anxiety. So what happens is when you're anxious about something, it is quite obvious, you know, looking at the current scenario and the scenario of students as well as people, anxiety is something which we come across on, I would say, on a daily basis, or very frequently. When the anxious thoughts interfering with that, and they are causing a significant distress, I would like to underline this point that they are causing significant distress. That is something you should always suppress. You know, you should go it, push the boundaries, and go ahead. And this is really something that you can get with. So.
Hello everyone, I guess there is some internet issue and Shreya will join back again. Hello, can everyone hear me?
Oh yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, so I guess the problem is with Shruti's internet and she will join back again.
Is it okay that until then I continue what she was saying?
Yeah, sure,
and anyway,
sure.
Next I'm going on, so we will not waste time. Just give me 1 minute. Yeah, okay. So basically what she's saying that sometimes it happens that you're not able to manage your emotions by yourself and they become very overwhelming for you, and it happens with everyone. So it is important for you to differentiate between what you feel normally and something when it becomes very serious. Then you really need to go to some mental health professional. There are certain signals which you can recognize. Something like if those emotions and that feeling is interfering in a lot of daily issues of your or your occupation, your work space, your home, if they are coming in between, then it is definitely you need to see some professional. Itchy back. Okay, no, sorry. Theek hai. So next I will be moving to how do you manage and deal with emotions from your end. So now we know that we are not born knowing how to manage emotions. So this means that we have to learn it. Now, how do we learn it? Is that we learn from all kinds of experiences and other people, including our parents, our friends, our teachers, and society in general. So now that we know that we cannot label emotions to be good or bad, but sometimes it happens that we are really burdened by those emotions and we get really stressed because we cannot deal with them. In such times, it is very important for us to be able to deal with those emotions, and hence I am going to help you a little bit with this model. You can call it as ABCDE model. It's a very interesting and a very easy activity you can do. So now, can any one of you give me any situation or example where you feel very angry or very sad and you are not able to express your emotions, or any situation you can share?
Okay, so any situation where we feel a lot of anger?
Yeah.
Right.
Anything which makes you feel very intense emotions.
Okay.
I guess when someone betrays us or someone breaks our heart or something like that, maybe.
Okay, yes. Okay, so very beautifully said. So here, the activating event, which is A, will be what is the situation. So why do you feel that somebody is breaking your heart? There might be some situation or some event that occurred which makes you feel that somebody is breaking your heart. So what can be that situation? You need to find out. Okay, so they did not reply you back, or they did not call you back. They didn't ask you how you were. So something like that is a situation which you need to identify. Okay, so this is the situation why I'm feeling this way. So when you are able to recognize the event or situation that is making you feel that way, it is important to understand the belief or thoughts that are put behind that emotion. So now you say that somebody is betraying me or they are hurting me. What thoughts are going in your head? So I might be feeling that, okay, nobody loves me. I'm not good enough. People just care about themselves and they do not care about anybody else. So such thoughts or beliefs we build behind our emotion. And it is very important to recognize those thoughts, because a lot of time it happens that those thoughts leads to how intense the emotion you are feeling. Okay, so once you recognize the thoughts and belief, it comes to C, that is consequences. Now it is important that how did you feel that emotion and what did you do as a result of that belief. Now I believe that I am not good enough for anybody and nobody can love me. As a consequence, I am doubting myself. I am not involving with anybody else. I am not talking with anybody else. I am isolating myself. So this is the consequences which is coming out of the thoughts. Now, this is the things that you need to recognize. Now, where you have to take action is D, basically. So D is disputation. In disputation, what you need to do is you have to challenge or reframe the thought or belief that is behind your emotion. So when you say that I am feeling very hurt or I am sad because somebody did not call me back, what am I doing is that I am saying that I am not good enough. But if I change, and because I am saying that I am not good enough, it is leading to more sadness, it is leading to more hurt. So that thought is increasing the intensity of my emotion. So when I reframe that belief that no, I am good enough, and it is only, it happens that the person might be busy, there might be some reasons that he is behaving like that or she is behaving like that, but that doesn't mean that I am not good enough. There are a lot of other people, there is my family, there are my friends who really love me and who care about me. So when you put it this way, when you reframe your thought, automatically the intensity of your emotions will be less, or you won't feel that bad that no, I'm not good enough, because you're somehow by those negative thoughts you're boosting those negative emotions. Now when you're done with disputation, the next step is energization. How do you feel after disputing the belief is very important. So what happened, what changes happened in your mood? So when I said that I'm not good enough and I'm not able to, you know, nobody loves me and I'm not, my self-esteem is somewhere hampered. But when I said that, no, it's okay. Sometimes people cannot be there for me and sometimes I have to be there for myself. When I say that, what am I doing is that I'm feeling much better about myself. I'm also feeling much better about the person in front of me. So this is a simple model. Whenever you're feeling very angry or very sad, you can just take out a page. You can write these A, B, C, D, E points and you can try to, you know, reflect on your emotions and try to understand what exactly you're feeling and why you're feeling that. Now moving forward, this is something which is emotions regulation.
Okay, I'm just sorry to interrupt you right now.
Yeah.
So like the thing that you said before, the ABCDE model. So, you know, there are sometimes you just go through situations where you really can't figure out what you're going through. And maybe there isn't anything specific that just makes you feel bad. It's just like a generic thing, like kuch aise proper situation nahi hai, you know, like this situation has made me feel bad about something or something like that. It's just very random that sometimes you feel low and there isn't a particular situation or a particular problem to that thing. So at that time, it's very hard to, you know, like figure out things like what are you sad about, what are your feelings, are you like angry, are you upset or something. So it's very hard to figure things out. But then what to do then? It's like even if you're like with your friends, you have many people around you, you still feel alone.
Yeah, the reason here can be that there has to be some situation or specific, you know, event which with which your emotion is associated. So it can happen a lot of times that I'm in middle of friends, a thought crosses my mind, which is not really related at that moment, but it is just unconsciously present and it also affects me. So it is very important for you to introspect on that or have some, try to get some insight on what exactly, why exactly you're feeling that, even if you're surrounded by people, is it that you're not able to connect with them? Or is it somewhere that you have certain feelings about them, which are, you know, you're not happy with them or something like that. So you have to find that reason or situation which is connected to that emotion. Okay. I will also give you some of the, you know, first aids or tips which will help you later. But for you, I have this answer right now.
Okay, so it's like if I analyze my so if I analyze my situation right now, it's like my life is like going very smooth. There is not any problem or something like that. And it's like, you know, like you should know how to deal with your problems. And I know that thing, you're like helping everyone with it. But it's just sometimes you don't feel good about something.
Okay. Can you give me any example when do you feel that, or what you're doing before and after that, or any thoughts that crosses your mind before you're having that feeling?
Yeah.
Hello? Hello?
Hello? Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. It's nothing like that, you know, like sometimes I just suppose that I'm happy, but I really don't know if I am. You just like get what I'm saying?
Yes. Okay. See, can I just ask you a lot of times we
So you just need to like tell us like in generic thing that, you know, it's sometimes when you really can't figure out things, when you know you get into a situation like these when nothing specific has happened, how to deal with it.
Okay, so I would like to say that a lot of time it happens that from a very long period of time, we are trying to, you know, hide some feelings or hide some emotions that are, you know, been there for a very long period, where we have in past, even let it be a lot of days before, we have tried to, you know, bury some emotions, or we have let go of some things, and we are not able to, we have not any closure with them. So in that situation, it can be that they are still present somewhere inside you. And, you know, it will be really helpful for you if you try to express what you're feeling whenever you're feeling it. And also, you know, to connect with people and to tell them what exactly you're feeling. Maybe you will be able to recognize it when you are voice it out.
I actually do that, to be honest.
Okay.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
Hi. So, you know what, Kalyani, I just have one way to maybe help you out. I don't know if this is going to work for you, but what you can do is, you said that you really don't know what emotions you're feeling, and you think that your life is all good and you're happy, but you really don't know if you're happy.
Yeah, so that's what I'm asking about.
Yeah.
That's what I'm coming to your answer. Right now. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm coming to your answer. So what you can do is, you first need to understand what is your definition of happiness. Okay? So when you understand, 1 minute. Hello, sorry, my sister was just screaming. Okay, so you need to first understand what is your definition of happiness, because not necessarily that what everyone's definition of happiness is your definition of happiness. You can feel happy for like small little things, but for someone else it might be a big gesture that made them feel happy. So first you need to understand what your happiness is, and the next thing is, you first also need to understand what your goal is. For that moment when you're clueless, when you tell yourself, no, but I'm not supposed to feel this, because everything around me is just perfect. I am really grateful for the things, and also I'm very privileged, so there's no need for me to feel what I'm feeling right now. That is the time when I feel that you need to understand what your goal for that time is.
Okay.
You need to be mindful about what is going on around you, because
yeah, so like basically analyze the situation a bit differently, right?
No, I'm not saying you need to really analyze the situation. What I'm saying is, you need to, you know, this is where the self-talk comes. You need to ask yourself what is happening. You need to talk to yourself. What is my goal? At this point, what is the emotion that I want to feel? And if I'm not getting away, look around. Be mindful about it. Tell yourself, okay, these are the things around me, and if I want to get out of this emotion, this is what I can do. I can put on music and I can listen to it.
Yeah,
and that is
cool.
The point where, you know, surrounding yourself with people might not help as much as
being you're alone. Here. Yeah, just yeah, I get that thing. Thank you so much, Siddhi.
Yeah, no problem. So, you know, just try to, I think in the previous webinars that we had, we did talk about it. So, you need to be smart because not every what everyone does is not something that is necessary for you that it will help you.
Yeah, so it's like each and every person has a different way of healing, right? Yeah, I get that thing. Thank you so much.
Amazing. Does this answer your question, Kalyani?
Yes, really beautifully explained.
Amazing. Thank you so much. So, Pranita can continue, right?
Yeah, now. I will move forward now. So, I was talking about emotion regulation. Now, what is emotion regulation? Is that it is a term generally used to describe a person's ability to effectively manage and respond to an actual emotional experience. So how do we deal with any particular emotional experience and how do we manage it? It is very important. So every one of us unconsciously using some emotion regulation strategies to deal with those. Some of us might use positive ones, but some of us tend to use, negative or unhealthy emotion regulation strategies. So first of all, I would like to say that emotions, you know, as shown in this picture, are like, it's a cluster of a lot of emotions. May it be happy emotions like love, pride, empathy, trust, or it can also be sadness, rage, boredom. So you have to balance it out so that you can regulate them properly. Now we'll look into the healthy and unhealthy emotion regulation strategies. Now healthy, you can see here, are talking with friends, exercising, writing a journal, meditation, therapy, taking care of yourself when physically ill, or getting adequate sleep, paying attention to negative thoughts that are happening before and after of your emotions. Now, I won't go into details in this one because later on I'm coming up with the positive strategies. But it is very important to see here that unhealthy ones, because we have to be aware of them and we have to stay away from them. Okay, so unhealthy emotion regulation strategies, which are here, are abusing alcohol or other substances. A lot of time it happens that when we are trying to run away from certain emotions or experiences, we tend to drink or, you know, take in substances. But what happens is that you're just, hiding or running away from that problem for that amount of period when you are under any intoxication. But once that effect of alcohol or other substances reduces, it will definitely, it will affect your mood as well again, and you will feel those emotions intensely again, and then you become dependent on those substances. So it's a very unhealthy kind of a strategy. Another one is self-injury. A lot of people think that if I injure myself physically, the emotional pain might decrease, but it will not happen like that, and it is not at all suggested, and it's a very wrong and unhealthy emotion regulation strategy. Avoiding and withdrawing from difficult situations. Now, a lot of people suggest us in our everyday lives that, okay, you're sad, just, get involved in work. Kuch nahi, kaam karte rahe, you will forget about it. Just don't bother about it, But what is happening here is that we are running away from that emotion, or we are trying to bury it inside, but avoiding it, you can't avoid it for very long time. At some point, you will have that breakdown period, and the emotions will be so intense that it can even turn into some, emotions, or it can turn into some disorders as well, psychological disorders. So it's very important that you vent out your emotions and you pay attention to them when you are feeling them. Physical and verbal aggression, we all know. Excess social media use. So to ignore the problems, to ignore the emotions, we are involved in social media accounts. We try to post pictures to make ourselves feel better. But there are a lot of healthy ways to that. And please, we will try to use those. Exclusion of others' responsibilities. Basically, when we feel that this responsibility is giving me a lot of negative emotions, we try to run away from that responsibility. So I might have stage fear. So I completely withdraw, or I completely, you know, try to stay away from the opportunities where I have to present myself somewhere. But doing this is only increasing your anxiety, and it is only increasing your fear. So it's always better to, you know, have much more healthy strategies than the unhealthy ones. Moving forward.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, sure.
Yes, so what is the difference between negative healthy emotions and negative unhealthy emotions?
But the emotions that make us feel, I can say sad, or which we feel that we have a pain due to those emotions, I'm terming them as the negative ones, because I have to differentiate somewhere that happy emotions and the sad ones. Maybe that will be the better word to use it, because we already said that you should not label. But it's just that the term I'm using is just to explain that the sad emotions that we are facing.
Okay, sure. Thank you so much.
Is it better?
Question. Yeah.
I also want to ask the question, can you explain what the conscious and the subconscious mind are?
So right now I'm not prepared for that answer, so I might not be able to, give it properly, but I think we'll get back to you after the session.
My question actually was I have read a lot, and I read a lot about the subconscious mind and what the subconscious mind is capable of, and how you can affirm and pull strings to make things happen. Like, you have to put in work, but the subconscious mind is very powerful. So can you explain it more? Can you add a certain clarity?
I will definitely do it after the session if it's fine, because it's somewhere, I agree that it is related to this topic, but right now we are trying to just focus on how do you manage emotions on basic level. So I'll just continue with that. At the end, I'll try to get back to you. Okay. Yeah. Now that we saw that, how do we deal with those emotions and the model, but this is, specially named it first state for managing emotions, because a lot of times it happens that you get very strong emotions, and at the point you don't know what you have to do and how you're going to deal with it. So at that point, it is very important for you to have some techniques or learn some ways where you can, deal with those at that moment. So the first and very important thing is that don't act right away, or don't react right away. Because what happens is that when we are under a very, intense emotion, reacting immediately to that trigger can be a very big mistake, because we tend to say a lot of things, or we tend to do a lot of things that later we'll regret when we are calmed down. So before reacting to the trigger with your emotional argument, you have to, give yourself some time. You should not react directly, but give yourself some time. When you give it some time, then we are moving forward to deep breathing. Any emotional response or any extreme emotion always leads to some bodily changes, like your heart races, you have palpitations, or sometimes, you're very angry and you don't know what to do. You are just throwing things here and there. At that point, it is very important that you calm your body and your physical, calm your physique down. So for that, deep breathing is a very important thing, which will help you to calm your heart rate to normal. And as you become calmer, affirm to yourself that this is only a temporary thing and this is not going to last forever. So I don't have to, react it so intensely to it. I just need to calm down for right now, and then later I'll deal with it. Next comes is that questioning your emotions. So as we are saying again and again, that your emotion is always trying to tell you something, and it is trying to get your attention to some situations or some things that are linked to your behavior. It is very important that you keep questioning your emotions. And when you get those answers from your questions, you will get really logical and rational answers, and the intensity of emotion will lessen. So questions like, what am I feeling exactly? So don't just say that I'm feeling good or bad. Be specific that it is sadness, or is it anger, or is it disappointment? And try to find the exact word for that feeling. And when did you notice it, and why you're feeling? So ask a lot of questions to your emotions, and that will decrease your intensity. Then comes replace negative thoughts. So as we said that every emotion is backed up with certain negative or positive thoughts, and those thoughts lead to that emotion. So changing thoughts is much easier than changing your feelings or emotions. Thoughts play a very critical role in how we experience a particular situation. So when you notice that you are getting really upset, try to evaluate what you're thinking that is causing the emotion. So what happens is that there is a cycle that if you have any negative thought, it will tend to that particular emotion and that burden. And again, due to that emotion, you're again feeling very negative thoughts. So it becomes a cycle. And to break that cycle, it is very important for you to change or replace that negative thought. Then comes trigger management. In trigger management, you know, it is always better to know what triggers your emotions. So I might have certain situations or certain events which might have a very strong impact on me, and they might trigger some of the emotions that I'm facing. So it's always better to, you know, recognize those triggers and try to work on those triggers. Like if I should practice that if I face this situation, how should I react to it positively? And it will really help you, because you realize that you can intervene in the space between the trigger and the response. And in that meantime, you can, you know, give more efficient responses. Then comes is safe space imagery. It is a very simple and very interesting task where you can just close your eyes, create a safe place in your mind. So what is a safe place? Basically, a place that you feel that you really like. So don't let it be your home or any familiar place. Just close your eyes. Imagine any place that you love. So some might be loving sitting on a, you know, beach and listening to the waves of the sea. And some might love sitting on mountains and, you know, feeling that breeze. So close your eyes and imagine that space, and imagine that you're sitting in that place. Take all that imagery scenery in, and, you know, try to reflect on it. It will also calm down your breathing. And whenever you feel that intense emotion, sit, close your eyes and visit that imagery space. It will help calm yourself down. Next comes is that find a healthy outlet. Now that we know that we cannot run away from the emotions and that we cannot bury them inside, it's very important to find an outlet to express those emotions. Now we cannot express them in unhealthy manners, but we have to express them in the healthy ones. So, you know, emotions should never be bottled up. So you can call someone and express. So you can tell them that what happened and what you are feeling. In that also, you will find the pattern that, okay, so I did this, so this event happened, and that's why I'm feeling this. So even you get to hear yourself, and when you're speaking out loud, it helps you to, you know, understand that emotion and that experience. You can keep a journal and transfer your emotions to that journal so that it will, you know, lessen your burden. You can take up dance, you can take exercises, kickboxing, martial arts, anything that is discharging your feelings. You can meditate, anything that makes you feel better and gives you an outlet.